I graduated medical school knowing almost nothing about nutrition. That's right, the number one thing that determines how you feel, how you look, how long you live, how well you live, was barely a part of my medical education. Now, I would love to tell you that I was an exception, that I was a bad student, didn't study, didn't go to class, or just went to a crappy school. Unfortunately, none of that is true. I went to a good school, tough to get into, good reputation, and I actually had pretty good grades. Unfortunately, my situation is pretty typical. In the US, for example, med schools are expected to offer a minimum of 25 hours of nutrition instruction. That's total 25 hours over all of med school. So the equivalent of 3 full days of classes in 4 years. And if that seems scanty to you, the reality is even worse, because less than a third of med schools actually meet that minimum. The average is less than 20 hours of nutrition classes over the 4 years. So given this reality, the result is exactly what we would expect. Most doctors are not prepared to give nutrition advice. 94% of doctors think it's their obligation to discuss nutrition with patients, but only 14% feel they are adequately trained to do it. Now, there are many ongoing efforts to try to change the situation, and I am absolutely sure that eventually they will work and things will change. But in the meantime, we have to protect ourselves, and nothing is more empowering than knowledge. When it comes to nutrition, the available knowledge is just staggering. I mean, literally life-changing. In fact, when I started researching and studying nutrition more in depth, I was blown away. Not just by what I was learning, the amazing facts themselves, but by the fact that I had gone so long without knowing this stuff. And I don't mean academic details, nerdy, boring minutiae. I mean essential, fundamental stuff that everybody should know. Forget med school. We should be taught this stuff in elementary school. Heart disease can be reversed. So the number one cause of death in the Western world affects 50% of us, will kill a third of us, is largely avoidable and largely curable. And that's with no drugs, no side effects or procedures, just by eating a certain way. And get this, I never heard that in medical school, not once. Diabetes is also preventable with food. So is high blood pressure. And obviously weight issues and obesity, which is now an epidemic. Childhood obesity has more than tripled since the 70s. If things continue this way, more than half of today's children are expected to become obese adults. Think about that for 1 second. Having normal weight will be an exception. In fact, it won't be called normal weight anymore because it won't be normal. Obese will be the new normal. Clearly, we don't know what we're doing when it comes to food. Now, all of that said, I like to look at everything through a positive light. Everything in life has an upside. For the longest time, people didn't have this knowledge, but now we do. Scientists have figured out all the basics, and we're the lucky ones who get to benefit. Let's say I hear something about nutrition. Food X or Y is good or bad for me. In a matter of seconds, I can pull out my phone. I can find professional, peer-reviewed work done by world-class experts. I can check their work, read their conclusions, and apply them to my own life. In the history of humanity, this was never possible. Our ancestors never had these resources. At the same time, most people don't know this is possible and are not sure quite how to do it. So when I was researching and reading and learning all these amazing facts, it really got me thinking. If even doctors aren't aware of this, then who's warning everybody else? People who didn't go to med school. People who don't do research for a living. Who's telling them? So that got me making these videos and giving seminars to help spread the message a bit. So we know having an MD doesn't mean you know nutrition. We know that. But we should also not fall into the opposite trap of thinking every doctor is ignorant or in cahoots with Big Pharma or something. That's just as false and probably more dangerous. In fact, many of the leading nutrition experts are MDs. And many doctors, of course, continue to learn and educate themselves. I took it upon myself to read as much as I could for years, to listen to leading experts. To this day, I'm learning every single day. And of course, many doctors out there do the same and become very knowledgeable in this field and give fantastic advice. But some of the worst, most unscientific advice you will hear, both online and offline, sometimes comes from MDs. That's really confusing. What the hell are we supposed to do? Well, we have to be critical of what we hear. It's the best way. It's the only way. Get used to asking for sources. If the advice is based on scientific evidence, there will be published studies you can look up and verify the information. If, on the other hand, it's word of mouth, unreferenced blogs, just personal opinion, then you know it's not at the same level as evidence-based advice, no matter who it comes from. One of the first videos I ever made goes over how to find and access these scientific studies. At the end of the day, nutrition science is not that hard to digest. But if that's not your thing, I totally get it, and there are simpler approaches. Even just getting in the habit of Googling foods and doing a quick check on that nutrition info table on the right side of the search page can teach you some crucial lessons. Most people have no idea what they're eating, and the truth is there's a lot of industries out there that like to keep it that way because they profit from that ignorance. So learning from solid sources is absolutely essential. At the end of the day, eating a healthy diet is not that complicated. You don't need a PhD in this stuff. My last video was 30 minutes and I covered all the basics you need to know to have a very healthy diet, minimize your risk of disease. So feel free to check it out, and I'll keep making more videos on any issues that arise. So stay informed, and I'll see you on the next one.